wasn't gonna say anything, but honestly, you probably spent about $8 in duct tape when you could have spent less than a dollar on a hefty garbage bag, put the garbage bag in there, and not done that. This isn't Pat's fault. Somebody else did this. Clean. So we've taken the door panel off of the F-250. The crazy thing about that is we actually had to put the door panel back on because Pat took the door panel off so that we could take the door panel and put the stuff on the door panel, which I wasn't gonna do that because I always tell people when we do these kind of things that if we do one, you get to do the other. That's what the video is for. Take it home and learn. And after the break, everybody gets a chance to learn. All right, now the first thing I'm gonna talk about is what is not available for these door panels. Now this door panel is one out of a 1985 F-250 XLT Lariat truck. It was the top of the line trim option on those particular pickup trucks. And what I'm gonna discuss first is what you can't get, because these are gonna be some problem areas for you when you're trying to fix one of these trucks up and make them look really nice. Number one thing that's not available is this stainless trim around the outside perimeter. You can't get that anywhere. Another thing that's not available is the speaker grille. This is not out in the aftermarket yet either, although this does kind of remind me of the 71-3 speaker grills on the Mustang. I don't think they're available yet for the truck. Another thing that's not available right now is this red escutcheon plate that's on the XLT Lariat trim package, and it's also just the XLT. This one is not available, nor is this velour, this lovely soft velour, is not available in the aftermarket. Another thing that surprisingly has not been made available yet, because it's on every one of these trucks, is this escutcheon plate right here, this soft plate that goes around the door handle hole. So you can't get that. But the cool thing is, now I'm going to talk about what you can get, and it blows me away that this stuff is available. Last week we talked about the switches being available. You can also get the escutcheon plate for the door unlocks on the 85, along with even the button that's available for those. So that's really nice. This armrest is also available. So it's really cool that you can get this, because one of the things going to happen to Pat is once I put this on the new door panel, this is going to look old and tatty. Trust me. Going to be the same thing with any of these other parts. But we're going to get to that when we put the door panel on, which I've got the new one from National Parts Depot here. We're going to bring that in and start talking about that right now and talk about the good and the things that kind of distress me a little bit about it. All right, so this is the door panel that we got from National Parts Depot. What I will say initially is this piece is plastic. It is a ABS molded panel. I'm not going to set it down on there because it's a painted molded panel. It's actually pretty nicely done for ABS. I will say that. It's not as bad or hideous as it might could be. But there are some problems that come along with ABS molding, and one of those problems is this is supposed to be a French seam. The molding on it, because of it being an ABS blow molded piece, is not going to be great. Your graining is pretty decent on it. It actually doesn't look too bad, but you're going to see some problems with the molding not taking the grain really well on these really small, hard cornered surfaces. I would say that this is a better than driver piece. These are getting really, really hard to find in the salvage yards. When you find them in the yards, 9 chances out of 10, the whole panel is pretty much trashed. The other thing you're gonna have is, like, this has got a speaker grill that's on the top of it. The original panels just had slots cut into the panel itself. But the nice thing is this is a separate grill that you can take off. So we'll be going in and taking off the speaker in here. Now the reason we're replacing this is these panels on top get sun bleached and damaged. The UV just eats them up and they'll start to do what I like to call granola-ing. Because if you've eaten granola, it's kind of what this looks like. And there's really no good way to fix it. We talked off camera. Cam's here today, but he's running a camera because we're down on crew a little bit this afternoon. But we were talking about maybe you could fix this, and I really have not found a good way to fix these panels. So I looked at the replacement and I thought that's probably the best option at this point. Trying to find used ones online, they're getting to a point where they're actually pretty expensive. And then you have to re-dye them anyway, so I don't know that this is kind of a mox nix, so to speak. What I'm going to do first, I'm going to show you the product I like to use for this. I am not selling this stuff. It's just what I use, and it's AutoSol metal polish. There are tons of metal polishes out there that you can use. This is the one I prefer. It's made by Germans. They make good stuff. Hope you get the reference. So I'm gonna take some of this stuff out, put it on my rag here, and I'm just gonna clean up the stainless on this panel using my AutoSol. That way, if I get it on the actual panel itself, I don't really care. And I'm just gonna go all the way around this thing while I've got it mounted up so it stays nice and stable. And you see it pulling on the rag here, so you know that it's taking something off of the panel itself. The one thing you do wanna do is to make sure you don't get the AutoSol on your beautiful velour. Okay, so I'm gonna flip this thing over and start taking these clips loose. I'm gonna go ahead and remove the center piece first. And I'm gonna use my plastic spatula for this. So you take and run it up against it and flatten it out. And you're gonna do that for all of these. Now that's just held on with a series of Phillips head screws. That's pretty easy and straightforward. And the new door panel actually mimics this pretty well, so that's good. All right, my armrest fell off. I'm gonna pull my clip out so I can take that out. That should basically fall out now. Set that aside for a second. Now, the cool thing is if you look at the edges here, you can see just how much this interior has discolored from sun and all. If you can see this section right in here and how bright red that really originally was. Really looked cool brand new, but velour, it's an evil thing because after a long time out in the sun, it'll turn sort of a brownish red color like this. All right, now I'm gonna show you how to take these kind of clips off. These clips are a nightmare. Because you don't want to break the pins on here because that's your locator for that part of the chrome trim on the door panel. What you want to do is you want to get your screwdriver under the edge of it and roll that pin up. Roll that side of it up, rather. And then they loosen up and you can take them off. Now, in order to reinsert them, what you can do also then is take and put it in a pair of needle nose pliers and then just push the ends of it back down to where it flattens out and then it'll go right back down on the pins like it's supposed to. Okay, now these clips are much more prone to breaking off than the ones that are on the backing card for the insert panel here. We've already busted one and I didn't even hardly pick it up. I just started moving it and it broke over. They'll do that. You have to be very careful with them and I'm really you just want to make sure that they don't bust. So I try to be more careful with these than I am with the other ones even. All right, now, what I do with these kind of clips is I'm going to try and put the put a dental tool. You can buy these at Harbor Freight, places like that. Get the dental tool down in there and pick that edge up on it and roll it over till it loosens up. There we go. That's it. Yep. And that's how you get that out of there. Now we can take the stainless slash chrome molding off. Flip it over. All right. Grab that off of here gently so I don't break it. I'm gonna set that aside and we are now basically done with this, with the exception of taking this escutcheon plate off, and that's pretty easy. It's just a push and pull. So I'll take that off camera. All right, now what I'm gonna do is I've got the panel set up. I've got a white colored pencil and I'm gonna just mark the basic positions for these studs. Looking straight down on top of it. I will say that it's not super critical as for the positioning. I'm going to make the holes big enough that it's not going to be too big of a problem, I don't think. Now when I go and I make my holes in these, I'm going to make them, try to get them in the center of where the French seam is on the panel. Sometimes when these things are made, I'm always a little puzzled why the companies don't work from original components sometimes. but they don't, and that's just how it is. All right, now I'm gonna go ahead and use a small drill bit to make my guide hole for my bigger drill bit. This will be a lot easier to control theoretically. The nice thing with ABS is it's ABS and it drills fairly easily. Don't drill your hand either while you're doing this. Now, the bigger bit that I'm using is just one that we grabbed, and it's basically to the same size as the holes on the original door panel. If you have all the clips, you're going to do this 18 times. Now the horrifying moment of truth. We turn it over, and we hope that our holes are all in the right spot and that the panel will fit. Now we got to remember, like I said, that this is an aftermarket panel, so we don't know if we're going to have decent fit or not. We are off a little bit at the front for sure. Here's the thing, I think I can make this work, but it's not going to be absolutely correct for mounting. I can make the top line in very decently. I'm going to have to go in and re-drill these holes here along the base again because my hole is not quite where it needs to be, so I'm just going to have to open those up a little bit. Otherwise, I think we can make this work. If you look at it, you can see that this piece is sitting out of the line here a little bit. This is a problem sometimes whenever you have things like what Ford did. Their XLT panels were different from the base panels. I had always assumed that Ford Motor Company made these panels like this one, where they were all the same panel. Nothing was different, and they just put the board over the top of it or whatever. But in fact, Ford had a different panel for the XLTs because this is all smooth, whereas on the XL trucks and just the straight up XLTs there's a panel that would go here. It's completely different from those two. So that just lets you know that Ford didn't just do one panel for these things. So Dashtop, if you're watching, you might want to consider making one that'll fit the XLT and the trim. But like I said, this panel is not necessarily, it is not designed for an XLT package with all the trim work on it, so just keep that in the back of your mind when you're doing this as well. And I'm gonna flip this one over and I'm gonna start working on the clips and bending them back in place. I just use my thumb for this to bend them back. I'm gonna put the clips back in these holes if I can to get these to set. This one is not going to set just simply because of what I'm going to show you next, which is how proud this sits up off of here. This is up in this top corner, way off from factory original, and I don't see a good way to get that to lay in like it should. It'll lay down better once I get the push pins back in here along this line and up this line here, but that corner has just really got a bad pressure point. Now I'm going to use a 9/32 deep well socket on a handle and try to get one of the more prominent ones to start up. Okay, I'm going to roll this up and put pressure on the back side or on the front side of it and then push it in with that. All right, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go in and set up for this plate here that backs the escutcheon for the power switch assembly here. And I'm going to do a measurement off of this to get a general slightly larger hole. I am not going to do the mammoth picture hole that Ford used back in the day. That's just too big in my opinion. I don't need it. So I'm going to measure off of this from the edge of this. And we're right at to the escutcheon plate about 6.5 inches. So I'm going to come in 6 1/4 off of this. All right, so now I'm gonna take and get my bottom measurement. I'm coming up probably 3 3/4 inches off of this bottom edge here. And then this plate is roughly 3 5/8 wide. So I'm gonna go 4 inches off of the back here. Maybe even go let's go 4 1/4. Remember, all this is going to be covered up by the plate itself. And then from the top, I'm going to come down 3 inches off the top of this. And we're already above that, so I'm just going to have to mark it out and make my positions and cut it. Oh, what the heck, this is right here. Luckily, I'm pretty good with making straight lines and level stuff. All right, now there's two ways you can do this. You can use a utility knife and score this and then break it over and break it out. I'm just gonna go grab my Dremel tool and cut that out with a Dremel. All right, now I've gone in and set my holes. This one is a little bit off, so what I'm going to do is widen the hole to the to that side of it. I'm just using a round file to do this. Okay. There we go. That's a bit better. Going to set up a little bit because of that other panel piece, and the back end is going to be a little bit off too. It looks like I'm going to have to go in and work. All right, this one right here is going to need to be opened up this way. This one is going to need to be opened up this way. The rest of these look like they're laying in pretty nice. I don't think any of the rest of them are a problem. All right, this is the final panel. There's a couple things I would probably do off camera that are not necessary for this thing to work. On this end of the door panel, I'm gonna pull this up where you can kind of see it. On this end of the door panel, the velour is, the actual under panel is sticking out a little too far on here. What I would probably do is go in and trim the base cardboard back a little bit, roll this edge, staple, and glue it down so it sits a little bit flatter. The other thing that I'm a little concerned with is just it sits up. And it didn't do that originally, but there's really not a lot we can do about that on here because of the style of panel that this is. You never know, in the next few years, we may be seeing some of these coming available. The guys at Dashtop or someone may come out with a really nice set of panels that will work with the XLT. Trim package, but for right now, if you wanted to do this, you can make it work. Is it perfect? No, because our chrome trim here sits out a little too far because of the way the panel was made. Little things like that are going to be annoyances for guys who are real purist on these trucks, but if you're just trying to make a really nice looking daily driver truck, this thing is going to be really good to that task. Even a mild show truck, I think most people at a car show are not going to sit there and gig you for this here as much as they might gig you for a really tatty looking top on these door panels. Well folks, that's our show for this week. Do me a favor and go out and check out our Patreon account. At the $10 a month level, we have monthly meetings with me on Zoom. We sit and we talk. We don't just sit here and watch me pontificate. We go back and forth. It's a really good time. Another thing I'd like for you to do is go out and please subscribe to the channel. Click that bell for notification. If you do not click that bell, you will not know anything that's going on Autorestomod or Man It Mechanic. So do that for me if you would please. Finally, and in all, be kind to each other, be nice to each other, love on each other. You guys have a great week and we'll see you next time on Autorestomod.
So Cam was behind camera today. His back's bothering him. Standing around hurts. So I didn't let him get out front. He is here today. Aren't you, Cam? Mm-hmm. See? You did, he's on the...
Almost sleeping.
Oh no, I woke him up. Darn.